third grade, so that's the right time to start getting aware that the world is significant. If you, you know, think about it from a point of view of math, science, so are you doing like elemental science, like simple biology or physics or
whatever? Yeah, a bit of everything actually.
Yeah, third grade, I think you just kind of expose them. Right.
Right.
That's pretty cool.
It's all about, you know, learning what NASA uses. You know, it's all about guided discovery. You know, experiments, and most kids love it the most, but they can do it. Space hop questions. It's a fun way of doing it, you know, where it's like three other subjects. It's sort of like more dictated in terms of the scope of what you do. So it gets a little bit more independent of what you're talking
about. I think, I mean, I'm biased, obviously, as an inherent. Our eldest is 25, she goes to Dunbury and psychology and environmental biology.
Yeah,
so another degree. Master's degree in environment science. So our son's currently doing pre-med biology. Our youngest is DIKS.
Okay.
And she likes
chemistry. Okay.
Well, I told the kids, look, I'm biased, but I only have two requests. Number one, do what you're passionate about.
Yeah. That's a key for anything.
And then work on something that is likely to get you a job that you're passionate about. And, you know,
I think that's a pretty good perspective. I
mean, you don't have to be a brain scientist, but there's plenty of jobs out there.
No, that's exactly right. I don't think that's success financing.
So somebody, you came here out of the blue and then found a job.
No, what happened was my girlfriend and I were teaching at a private school in Sydney, and we kind of
secular school or religious? Or?
No, it wasn't independent. And we've kind of been there for 5 years and decided to make
a change.
We didn't want to buy a house, we didn't want to have kids, so we decided to just get on the road.
Cool.
We took a year off and went through same school.
No, no, what did you
call it? Foundation. Sounds good.
That's great. Well, that's a great combination. And you found a school that took both of you.
Yeah.
That's not always easy to do.
No, no. It's set up. It's kind of like, I'm assuming that's what speed dating is like, rock up to your massive.
But it doesn't always mean you get to date, right? You don't close the gym all the time.
I mean, there were 600 schools, and you walk around and you get on the space on your CV, and they go, yeah, come back for another. It was kind of a weird concept. Online pursuits and kind of marketing yourself. And, It was interesting to see, so anyway, we wanted to come to Hong Kong, and that was our first choice. So we got to keep going.
Good night. Thanks, Adrian.
Good night.
So, I don't know. We don't know how long we're going to have it in our first job.
Oh, really?
Yeah. 4 weeks away.
Little girl.
Wow, congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. That's great. Now, we have three. We have a daughter, as I mentioned, and a son and a daughter. But I'm the oldest of seven.
Yeah.
I have four younger sisters and two younger brothers.
Oh, wow. Big family.
Catholic. Well, still is Catholic. Yeah. That's why I asked you. You said private school. Maybe you're teaching at a Catholic private school. That's true. I wasn't sure.
quite possibly. It's quite interesting.
Because all of us went to Catholic. Yeah. My kids have.
Right.
When we were growing up in America, we all went to Catholic. Yep. Nice touch.
Yeah. We're going to get
up. Okay, Brock, pleasure. We'll see you. I'm Tom. But we have two more matches. Yeah. Okay, we play team three.
Next time.
No problem. Hey, I probably won't see you till your kid's born. So congratulations on the birth of your new daughter.
I'm ripping my hair out by then.
Have a cigar too at the same time.
Yeah,
nice shot, Winnie. Take care, Adrian. Bye-bye.
Oh, still says that.
Nice shot.
I
thought
you
were. It was down. Not even close. Nice get.
Smart.